Extreme Trends presents, a stolen $160 million painting was found in this couple's home, and that was only the start of the mystery. Before we begin, do us a favor and click that like button. Also, subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to be inspired by these heartwarming stories every day. It's true that every house holds a secret within. It's just a matter of whether or not that secret will be revealed or be kept hidden forever. When a house in New Mexico was sold, a long-lost secret resurfaced and sparked intriguing mysteries. Jerry and Rita arrived in the small town of Cliff, New Mexico, sometime between the 1970s and the 1980s. Apparently, Jerry had been employed as a teacher in New York City prior to his retirement. He was also a self-published author and professed a love of adventure travel. Meanwhile, his wife Rita also had an educational background. She'd found work in local schools as a speech pathologist after the pair relocated to New Mexico. They were a pleasant couple, but little did their friends and neighbors know that Jerry and Rita were hiding a million-dollar secret behind the walls of their modest home. In 2012, Jerry died at the age of 81, and 5 years later, Rita also passed away. It then fell to the deceased couple's nephew, Ron Roseman, to distribute the estate. Roseman put Alter's Cliff home up for sale and invited local antiques dealers to look at its contents. David Van Auker, a dealer from the nearby community of Silver City, arrived at the Alter's home. He took interest in one painting in particular, a mid-20th century piece featuring an abstract interpretation of a naked woman. It had been hung in a peculiar place in Jerry and Rita's bedroom, displayed so that it could be only seen when the door was closed. Van Auker bought the property and took the painting back to Silver City. A visitor saw the Alter's painting on display and remarked that it appeared to be a genuine work by Willem de Kooning, an abstract expressionist from the Netherlands who became famous as part of the renowned New York school. Today, his work can sell for tens of millions of dollars. At first, Van Auker shrugged the outlandish claim, but when other customers began to say the same thing, the dealer began to wonder exactly what he might have acquired. Hiding the painting away in the bathroom, he took to the internet, and what he discovered left him amazed. Van Auker stumbled upon an article about a robbery that had taken place at the University of Arizona Museum of Art in Tucson, Arizona back in 1985. On the morning of November 29th, a man and a woman had arrived at the museum just as a security guard was unlocking the doors to admit a member of the staff. As the museum was about to open, the guard did not stop the couple when they stepped through the door as well. In fact, he soon started chatting with one, a woman thought to be around 55 to 60 years old. Meanwhile, the man, who appeared to be in his late 20s, wandered up to the second floor of the museum. After just a few minutes, however, the man returned and the pair left in a hurry. Suspicious, the guard went to investigate, only to discover that a valuable painting, Woman Ochre by de Kooning, had been removed from its frame. But by that time, the couple had disappeared, sparking a mystery that would baffle investigators for the next 30 years. Van Auker realized that the stolen painting and the one that he has might be one and the same. He telephoned the Tucson Museum, and they agreed to send a delegation to inspect the piece. Anxious, Van Auker remained awake throughout the night, protecting the artwork with loaded guns. The curator of the museum arrived, and experts were able to confirm Van Auker's suspicions. Yes, the quiet elderly Alters had somehow ended up with the stolen de Kooning on their bedroom wall. And by the time that the artwork was discovered, it was valued at a staggering $160 million. But did they just acquire the painting without knowing its origins, or was there something more sinister at play? Roseman believed his aunt and uncle were simply good with money, but the couple's inexplicable riches weren't the only suspicious thing about them. Journalists from the New York Times then discovered that the Alters had once owned a red sports car similar to the one seen driving away from the scene of the crime. On top of that, Rita had allegedly possessed a coat, scarf, and glasses similar to those worn by the female suspect. The oddest piece of the mystery, though, came in the form of a short story that Jerry published in 2011. In it, he wrote about a young woman and her granddaughter who befriend a security guard, only to return later to steal a valuable emerald from under his nose. Crucially, the tale ends with the jewel on display where only the two thieves could see it, very similar to the painting on their wall. Today, the painting is back at its home in the University of Arizona Museum of Art, and even though a year has passed since the artwork's discovery, the institution is still in the process of raising funds to restore it to its former glory. Meanwhile, there have been no arrests in relation to the mystery, and the Alters' friends and family remain baffled by the bizarre and unlikely chain of events. Thanks for watching until the end. Be sure to tap on the next videos for more incredible stories.